During their interface with officials of Arua Regional Referral Hospital over audit queries highlighted by the Auditor General's report, it came to the attention of legislators on PAC that the hospital is running without a mortuary, which is inconveniencing hospital users. Arua Central legislator Jackson Atima told the committee that absence of a mortuary is an embarrassment to Arua District, as dead bodies have to be transported to Nebi District to be preserved.
Specifically, the mortuary. Accounting officer, you are new in Arua Regional Referral Hospital, but you've been there before and you know the state of what we call mortuary now. We have raised it to His Excellency the President. We have raised it on the floor of Parliament. We have raised it everywhere. But your predecessor insisted that he didn't need a mortuary.
The matter was amplified by the committee chairperson of the day, Frederick Angura, who noted that the issue of Arua mortuary has been a center of discussions in Parliament for the last 3 years, with no action being taken. The committee then tasked the hospital to find funds and construct a decent home for the dead bodies.
So I thought the budget would now be focusing so much on stopping us from going to the mortuary. But in Arua, since we are all going to die, there is need for a mortuary.
Dr. Alex Andema assured the committee that they have been able to convince the Minister of Health to construct a mortuary for the hospital as an extension to the ongoing construction of the ICU at the hospital. They are looking at a 6-bed facility with fridges in the new mortuary.
So we are going to get a mortuary of 6 beds or 6 6-bed capacity for the fridges, no. 6 fridges. And the construction works actually started, is starting this week. The contractor is already on the ground.
According to the audit report, the hospital is also grappling with inadequate medical equipment like infant warmers, patient monitors, operating beds and headlamps, while other equipment including operating lights in the gynecology theatres were too old and damaged beyond repair, yet the X-ray duo diagnostic heavy-duty machine was non-functional, idle and redundant. The Auditor General also noted that a number of equipment were non-functioning, including one scanner, one weighing scale for infants, one infant incubator, 6 infusion pumps, 7 CPAP machines, and one boil machine. The hospital attributed this to limited resources.
With our funds, we always vote something for medical equipment. It's not adequate. We cannot get all of them at the same time. We always try to buy them. We get all the stuff together and we agree on which equipment needs to be bought.
The hospital is also grappling with other issues highlighted by the Auditor General, including congestion and shortage of nurses in the ICU and general wards, while in the accident and emergency unit, nurses and doctors are only available on call from other departments. In other revelations, the eye department has no doctor, while the ear, nose and throat department has old and rusted equipment. The maternity ward is also suffering a shortage of nurses with no privacy of waiting mothers.
But that issue will affect the service delivery.
For the benefit of the immediate people within Arua City and your immediate neighbors, attend to them and the guidance can come later, especially emergencies.
Story compiled by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.